is Houston Control. Checking for backup. Backup initiated. Locking out all ports. Clear. And we are good to go.
Welcome to another episode of Brent's Exciting Video Channel. Today we're going to have a serious discussion, and you know it's serious because I've got on a tie. In the last few, I'm going to say 3 or 4 weeks, I've had a couple calls a few issues related to this legendary machine, the SE-400. And so I thought today I'd do just a quick little, I'm going to call this pro tips when it comes to embroidery machines, because it's not a buying guide, because I'm not going to tell you how to buy, and it's not really a review of a product. It's just a couple things to look out for, a couple things to think about when you're buying an embroidery machine, especially an embroidery machine that does the humble 4x4 hoop. Because like I said, I've had a few calls about this SE-400, which is a popular machine apparently, and I was like, why am I hearing so much about these? So I go on Amazon, because as a brother dealer, I tend not to deal with these. So I go on Amazon and I'm finding that you can buy one for the rock bottom price of $329. Not a bad deal. If you're new to buying embroidery machines, the model that we sell here at the store is this guy here, the NS1750D. Whenever you're at a Brother sewing machine, the D designates that it will do Disney designs. Where you can pick this guy up for $329, give or take. Not sure what the shipping's gonna run you. This one here comes in for a street price, usually should be right under $1,000. I can't tell you exactly how much. You gotta come in and we gotta talk about it, because you know, other dealers don't like other dealers talking about what they're really selling machines for. So just suffice to say, you can get this thing, you can get this machine for under $1,000. I mean, that is three times the price of this. But we're going to talk about reasons why. There is another third machine that I don't have here today, because it's again, it's an Amazon model. I'm sure you can probably pick it up on eBay or any of the other sites as well. It's a PE-550D. I would encourage you, if you are looking at this, the SE-400, to consider the PE-550D. It is a much better machine. It's going to cost you $399 instead of $329. But the big difference will be that it does not sew. It is embroidery only. Something to consider, but if you are buying this machine to embroider, you're going to wish that you bought the 550D instead of the SE-400. Now, the problem I have with the SE-400, from a technical standpoint, from a guy that sells sewing machines to other people standpoint, is right here. Your ports. I mean, say nothing, the black and white touchscreen, yes, that's not uncommon for these machines at this price point, but a 550D, you can get a color touchscreen, which you'll be much happier with for embroidering, for $400, a little bit more, but I'll overlook the black and white screen for now. The big problem I have with this is our ports right here. You're going to notice right away, there's no standard USB port. You have a USB-B port or a USB printer port, which means you cannot put a thumb drive in this. This must be directly connected to your computer if you wish to use the USB port. But you'll be like, but wait a second. You've got USB, but what about the card slot? It has a card slot. I must be able to load embroidery patterns with the card slot. And this is where I get irritated. I don't know. I'm not going to blame Brother. I'm not going to blame the people selling this. I'm just going to be irritated by this in general. Because that card slot, as a dealer, I sell Brother machines. I have the Brother price list of things that I can buy from Brother. I cannot buy cards for this machine. Brother stopped producing embroidery cards probably close to 2 years ago, at least 2 years ago now. I think it's closer to 3 or 4. In fact, you'll notice on the V-Series, which is their high-end, which would include the Dreamweaver, the Dream Creator, and the Dream Machine, as well as the Luminaire. All those machines... the original Dream Machine is about 4 years old now, I think, if I remember my timeline correctly. That was never produced with a card slot. They stopped producing card slots on the high end when they phased out the Quattro. But yet, you can still buy this brand new on Amazon with a card slot. I can't get card slots as a dealer. I can't buy cards for the card slot. So you're going to have to spend another $80 on Amazon just to get the card reader and a blank card to transfer patterns from your computer two-year embroidery machine. That is a very big, and there's no excuse for it. The only thing I can think of is this SE-400. There's a ton of them out there because they probably didn't sell very well. So now they end up on Amazon for $329. The other thing I ran into, and I guess this is going to be more of a rant now, is this is the winner of a 9 out of 10 Women's Choice Award. What does that mean? I'll give you a second to let that sink in. This is an award-winning embroidery machine. 9 out of 10. And I'm thinking to myself, 9 out of 10 what? And so I went on to the Women's Choice Award website. And basically, somebody has a website called Women's Choice Award. And they award awards to products and services and things that women use. Because women, and it even says on the website, women are in control of 85% of all decisions made in the consumer household and blah, 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 blah. So they've decided that they're going to make a Women's Choice Award and put their seal of approval on different products. And then you look at their methodology, and their methodology is, oh, we interviewed people, we talked to people, would you recommend this? And, you know, sounds pretty decent. So basically, this won a 9 out of 10 award because everybody they asked, do you like your machine? Would you recommend it to somebody? 9 out of 10 people said, yeah, I would recommend this machine to somebody. And that makes sense to me. Because if you've never had an embroidery machine, this is a really nice machine. And it's going to be an exceptional sewing machine. For all its shortcomings as an embroidery machine, for the money, you're getting a lot of features and some great sewing capability out of it. If you buy this as a sewing machine, you will not be disappointed. If you buy it as an embroidery machine, you should have bought a PE550D at the very least. As a dealer, you know, I'm going to try and tell you this is the one you really want. But this is basically a 550D with sewing as well. So this is... But this, as an embroidery machine, is not the best machine in the world. So the only reason I can think that this has an award is because the people that said, yeah, it's a great machine, have never used a real embroidery machine. And I don't mean to say this isn't real, but at the end of the day, the Humble 4x4 is to get your feet wet. Anybody that does any serious embroidery will upgrade from this probably within 3 or 4 months. Some people will have one of these for 2 or 3 years and finally really get into embroidery, and then they'll come upgrade. The 4x4 is a nice place to start, but you'll outgrow it quick from an embroidery standpoint. The other problem, like I said, black and white touchscreen. Technology is at the point that you can now get a color touchscreen for under $1,000. I'm not going to get into the ins and outs of color versus black and white right now. Suffice it to say, on the Brother line, I can't say that this extends beyond Brother because I don't have enough experience with other lines. But you have much more robust editing features with the color screen versus the black and white. Plus, there's a big thing where you can layer your embroidery patterns. And if you ever want to see that, come to the shop and I'll explain it to you. But you want a color touchscreen. And like I said, the state of technology, you can get one. The PE550D for $399 on Amazon will have a color touchscreen. And it will be a decent embroidery machine for the money. The SE-400, this humble little machine here, is a great sewing machine. I would not buy this as an embroidery machine. And like I said, biggest reason is going to be your port issues. You'll notice this doesn't have a card slot. It doesn't even have the USB printer slot. It has a standard USB port so that you can just use a thumb drive, put it in your computer, download, and then put it on the machine. That is the state of technology for most embroidery machines at this point. Should at least, at the very least, have a USB port. There's really no excuse for it not to. That's why I have a lot of problems with this machine. If this machine had... You know, if you bought this machine 4, maybe 5 years ago, I could almost understand the card slot and the USB port. But if this machine is selling today on Amazon, and if somebody buys it as a seller, somebody that sells machines, I would have a hard time selling this to somebody without explaining it to them, the shortcomings of the port situation. In fact, if one of these came in on trade, I would sell this as a sewing machine only. I would not market this as an embroidery machine because it's going to have very limited features. It will embroider, but it's going to have limited functionality. So that's my rant slash pro tip. I'm really not sure what this is. But remember, this is a serious because I put on a tie for this. If I was in a t-shirt, you wouldn't have to believe anything I said, but I have a tie and a jacket on, so you know that this is good information. As a side note, I did read a study once that said men with facial hair are to be less trusted or perceived as less trusted. I didn't shave today, so that might offset the jacket and tie. Hope you enjoyed this rant, I don't know if you enjoyed it, but at least learn something from it. If you are in the market for an embroidery machine, consider those things. Make sure the ports are correct and look for at least a color touchscreen. SE-400, great little machine if you want to sew. If you want to embroider, look at least the PE-550D. I would really recommend this guy here for an entry-level machine because you may outgrow the embroidery, but it's always going to be a nice sewing machine. And I'll leave it at that. Again, feel free to comment in the comments below. Email me with any questions. I'm happy to answer any questions you may have about embroidery machines. If you're local, feel free to stop by the shop. We're always here to help. Thanks for watching, and hope to see you soon.